Very good morning to all my dear children. In today's max class, we are going to continue with the revision of chapter number 6, division. Are you ready for today's session? Yes? Now, so last class we saw till this, right? Again, once again, we'll revise this. So, divide the numbers. When you divide 0 by any number, what will be the answer? First question is A, 0. Divided by 7. So, we are going to divide the numbers. A, 0 divided by 7. Now, tell me the answer. When you divide 0 by any number, what will be the answer? Think and tell me the answer. Yes, your answer is 0. When you divide 0 by any number, the answer is 0. And when you divide a number by itself, same number, you'll get the answer as 1. Don't forget, when you divide 0 by any number, the answer is 0. And when you divide a number by itself, the answer is 1. And when you divide a number by 1, when you divide a third one, just see, when you divide a number by 1, what will be the answer? The number itself. So, 419 divided by 1 is equal to 419. Clear? And is this possible? Can we divide by 0? This is not possible. So, A sum 0 divided by 7 is 0. B1, 95 divided by 95 is 1. Third one, 419 divided by 1 is equal to 419. When you divide any number by 1, the answer is the same number. Next, D sum dividing by tens. So, 60 divided by 60. So, you can cancel these two. So, 6 divided by 1. What is the answer? When you divide any number by 1, if you have zeros in both the left and right hand side, so you can cancel the zeros. So here we have only 1 zeros in the left hand side and right hand side. So you can cancel 110 and the remaining 6 divided by 1 is? So when you divide any number by 1, what will be the answer? Same number, right? So 6. Or else in 10 tables, when you will get 60? 10, 6 are. So, 6 is the answer. If you have zeros in both the sides, you can cancel that. Clear? Next one. So, this we are going to see now. Fill in the boxes. So, now you know the... You are going to tell me the answer for all these things. So, now A sum 93 divided by dash is equal to 93. So, 93 with what we should divide so that we'll get the answer as the same one. 93 divided by 1. If we divide by 1, we get the number itself, isn't it? So, 93 divided by 1 is equal to 93. 93 divided by dash is equal to 93. When you'll get the same number, if you divide by 1. Next, when you'll get the answer as 1, when you will get the answer as 1, if you divide any number by itself, right, with the same number. So, 623 divided by 623. So, the answer is 1. So, just see the answer and you are going to write it accordingly. So, here we have 93, the same number. When you will get the same number? When you divide any number by 1, right? So, for sum, 93 divided by 1 is equal to 93. Second one, 623 divided by dash is equal to 1. When you'll get number 1 as answer, if we divide any number by itself. So, 623 divided by 623. And third one, and this is all the same way, dash divided by 1 is equal to 9. You will get the, if you divide any number by 1, you will get the same number, isn't it? So, this number only you will get it here, right? So, 9 divided by 1 is equal to 9. So, you are getting the answer. When you divide any number by 1, the answer is the number itself, isn't it? So that answer is the number, same number. So 9 divided by 1. So here we know the answer, but we are going to find out the question. So 9 divided by 1 is equal to 9. 9 divided by 1 is equal to 9. And next one. Okay, now tell me the answer is 0. When you'll get the answer as 0? Just see the answer. You're getting the answer as 0. When you'll get the answer as 0? When you divide 0 by any number, right? When you divide 0 by any number, answer you'll get it as 0. So 0 divided by 55 is equal to 0. I'll repeat the properties. When you divide 0 by any number, when you divide 0 by any number, answer will be 0. And when you divide any number by 1, the answer is the number itself. And then when you divide a number by itself, answer is 1. Next one. Divide and find the quotient. So here we are going to find out the quotient. Divide and find the quotient. You know what is quotient? Just see. We are going to divide the number 14 divided by 2. Here 14 is the dividend. And the number by which we divide. Which number we are going to divide? So 2 is the divisor. So now one answer we will get right. That is the quotient. Divide and find the quotient. We are going to find out the quotient. Shall we do that now? Yes, divide and find the quotient. So first sum, A sum is 14 divided by 2. Shall we do the first sum now? So 14 we are going to divide by 2. Now tell me 14 is the dividend, 2 is the divisor. And now this is the way 14 divided by 2 is equal to that we are going to find out. Now tell me in 2 table when you will get 14. 2 table when you will get number 14. I will say after 2 5s are 2 5s are 10. 2 6 are 12. 2 7s are 14, isn't it? 2 7s are 14. We got this right. So 2 7s are this 7 you are going to write at the top. 2 7s are this 14 you are going to write below this dividend. Where you are going to write? Below the dividend. Write 1, 4, exactly below that number. Okay, 14. 2 7s are, so when you multiply 2 7s are, what will be the answer? 14. 2 7s are 14, write it below the dividend. Now you are going to subtract these two numbers. 14 minus 14 is? 0. Very good. So now tell me, what is the quotient now in this sum? Yes, here 7 is the quotient. So divide and find out the quotient. What is the quotient in this sum? 14 divided by 2, 7. This 7 is the quotient. So you know what is quotient, right? Now, one more sum we'll do now. Yes, B sum. 25 divided by, see 25, that we are going to divide by 5. 25 we are going to divide by 5. We are going to find out the quotient, the answer. Now tell me in 5 table when you will get 25. 5 ones are 5. You can say that tables 5 ones are 5. 5 twos are 10. 5 threes are 15. 5 fours are 20. 5 fives are 25. Isn't it? So 5 fives are 25. So what you are going to do? Write this 5. So 5 fives are, this 5 you are going to write at the top, 25, write it below this dividend. And now you are going to subtract these two numbers, 25 minus 25 is 0. Very good, super. So you know what is quotient now in this sum, 25 divided by 5, what is the quotient? Yes, this is the quotient, right? 5 is the quotient, Q-U-O-T-I-E-N-T, quotient. Now, so you know how to do division, right? And one more sum. So 642 divided by 6. 42 divided by 6. Now in this sum, How are you going to tell me what is the question? Now in 6 tables, when you will get 42? So in 6 table, when you will get 42? 6. I will say after 5, 6 5s are 30. 6 6 are 36. 6 7s are 42. So 6 7s are, that 7 you are going to write at the top, 42. Write it below the dividend. And now we are going to subtract these two numbers, 42 minus 42. Answer is 0. So what is the quotient in the sum? 7. So you know how to find out the quotient, right? Now next one. 'Fill in the boxes.' A is dividend. Dividend they have given, and divisor also they have given. Quotient also they have given. Now how will you write this? So dividend is this one, 80. Divisor is with what number we are going to divide. So 18 divided by 2. What is the answer? In 2 table, when you will get 18? 9, 10. That is the quotient. So they have given all these things. How will you write this? So first dividend, you are going to write it first. 18. 18 is the dividend, right? 18 divided by, divisor is the number by which we divide. Which number we are going to divide? By 2. So 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. This you are going to write in the box. 18. So when the question is asked like this, dividend is equal to like that. So first you are going to write down the dividend. So write down 18 divided by dividend divided by, how is this dividend? D-I-V-I-D-E-N-D. Dividend divided by divisor. D-I-V-I-S-O-R is equal to quotient. Q-U-O-T-I-E-N-T. Dividend divided by divisor is equal to quotient. Now tell me, what is the dividend here? 18. 18 divided by, what is the divisor? By which number we are going to divide number 18? 2. Very good. So 80 divided by 2 is equal to 9. They have given the answer. So you can write directly 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. Write down 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. Now next sum. 21 divided by 3 is equal to dash. Now this we are going to find out. Now 21 divided by 3. What will be the answer? Quotient we are going to find out. So now 21 divided by 3. In 3 tables, when you are 21, we are going to divide by 3. Right? So in 3 table, when you will get 21? So 3 table, when you will get 21? I will say after 5, 3 5s are 15. 3 6 are 18. 3 7s are 21. So 3 7s are 21. So shall I write like this? 3 7 times, right? So 3 7s are 21. Now here 21 is what? 21 is the dividends, right? Dividend. Dividend. D-I-V-I-D-E-N-D. Dividend. And divisor. What is the divisor here? Yes, 3. By which number we are going to divide? 3. Yes, very good. And now, what is the quotient? 7. 21 divided by 3 is equal to 7. Here, 21 is the dividend. Divisor is 3. And quotient is 7. 21 divided by 3 is equal to 7. Now, next one. Circle the remainder in the following problems. Now, circle the remainder in the following problems. You know what do you mean by remainder? When the divisor does not divide the dividend completely. So, some number will be left out. Just see this. Here, some numbers are left out. Here, the divisor cannot divide the number completely. So, some number is left out, right? That number is called as remainder. See this below, this number is called as remainder. What do you mean by remainder? When the divisor does not divide the dividend completely, so some number will be left out. That number is called as remainder. Now, in this case, so first sum is 38 divided by 5. 38, we are going to divide by 5. Now, I will say the 5 table. 5 5s are 25. 5 6s are 30. 5 7s are 35. 5 8s are 40. 5 8s are 40. See, this 40 you cannot take as it's a greater number. 38 when compared to 38, 40 is greater. So this number you should not take. Okay, 5 8s are 40, you cannot take. So now go back to 5 7s are 35. So 5 7s are 35. So 5 8s are 40 we cannot take. So now I'm taking 5. Already it is there. So just for your reference, I'm doing all these things. 5 7s are 35. 5 7s are 35. So now subtract. 8 minus 5 is 3. So now tell me which one is the remainder in this sum? Yes, 3 is the remainder. 3 is the remainder. 3 is left out, right? That is the remainder. Now B sum, same. So 41 divided by 8. So 8 table, whether you will get 41? 8 table, we will not get number 41. 8 5s are 40. 8 6 are 8. 5s are 40. 8 6 are 48. Are we getting 41? We will not get 41 in 8 table. So what to do now? So you can take less than this number because we are going to subtract this, right? So now 8 6 are 48. Can we take 48? It is greater, right? So it is greater than 41. So we are going to subtract. We cannot subtract from a... We cannot subtract, right? 41 minus 40. This is possible. 41 minus 48. So we cannot take that number. So what we are going to do now? So 8 5s are 40. 8 5s are 40. Now subtract these two numbers. 1 minus 0 is 1. So what is the remainder here in the sum? 1 is the remainder. The number that is left out is the remainder. 8 5s are is 40. Write down below. So now 1 is the answer. Next one. Now in the sum, we are going to write the remainder. Write the remainder in the following problems. Write the remainder in the following problems. We are going to write on the remainder. Shall we write on the remainder now? So now they have given the question already. So we are going to write down only the remainder. First I'll explain. So in this sum, 28 divided by 3. How will you do this? 28 divided by 3. So in 3 table, whether we'll get 28. So 3 7s are 21. 3 8s are 24. 3 9s are 27. 3 10s are 30. Are we getting 28? No. So what to do now? So right, by 3 8s are 24. 3 9s are 27. 3 10s are 30. Right. So we cannot take 3 10s are 30 as it is greater. So now 3 9s are 27. So write down 3 9s are 27. Now we are going to subtract these two numbers. 28 minus 27. So now 8 minus 7 is? 8 minus 7, 1. 2 minus 2, 0. No need to write that. So what is the remainder in this sum? 1. 28 minus 27 is 1. 1 is the remainder. Next one, B sum. Same here, whether you will get 40 in 6 table? No. 6 6 are 36. 6 7s are 42. 42 you cannot take as it is, as the number is greater than 40, right? So 42 you cannot take, so leave that. So 6 6 are 36. So 6 6 are 36, it is already there. Now we are going to subtract these two numbers, right? So can you subtract 0 minus 6? No. So 3, this will become 10. 10 minus 6 is 4. So now tell me what is the remainder in this sum? 4 is the remainder. So, you know how to find out the remainder, right? And you know how to find out a quotient, how to find out a remainder. Isn't it, children? Practice well all the sums. One more word problem. Just only one word problem we'll do now. Yes. In a flower shop, there are 56 bouquets of flowers. So, while doing word problems, what you have to do? First, read out the question carefully. What you have to do? Read out the question 2 to 3 times till you understood the question, isn't it? So, how will you find out that it is a division sum? Already I mentioned you distributing equally. It comes under division, right? So, solve this word problem. We'll see. In a flower shop, there are 56 bouquets of flower. If 7 people buy, how many bouquets were there? 56. So, totally there were 56, right? 56. Now, if 7 people buy all the bouquets and distribute them equally, how many bouquets will each get? How many bouquets will each one will get? So, this is a division then, because as they were distributing equally, right? So, how many people were there totally? 7 people, right? So, totally 56 bouquets, 7 people. Now, we are going to find out how many bouquets each one will get, right? So, now how to find out? So, we are going to divide 56 divided by 7. So, 56 you are going to write it inside and 7 you are going to write it outside. 56 dividend, write it inside, and 7 the number by which we divide. 7 we are going to divide by 7, that you are going to write it outside. Now, tell me in 7 table when you will get 56. 7 5s are 35, 7 6 are 42. 7 7s are 49, 7 8s are 56. So, this 8 you are going to write at the top. 7 8s are 56. 56 minus 56, then you are going to subtract. 56 minus 56 is 0. So, what is the answer? 56 divided by 7, answer is 8. So, each person will get how many bouquets? 8 bouquets. Each person will get 8 bouquets. How to find out whether it is a division or multiplication sum? If it is, they are distributing equally, it comes under division. First, read out the question carefully. For word problem, first you have to read the full question. If you didn't understand the question, again read it one more time. Clear, children? So, in a flower shop, there are 56 bouquets of flowers. If 7 people buy all the bouquets, so totally before they were 56, initially there were 56 bouquets, right? And if 7 people buys all the bouquet, if 7 people buy all the bouquets, how many people now? 7. So now we are going to find out how they are going to distribute among themselves equally. So we are going to divide these two numbers, isn't it? 56 divided by 7. So, this is the method for dividing. You know this, right? So, 56 dividend, that you're going to write it inside. 7, write it outside. And when you'll get 56 in 7 table? 7, 8 times. 7 8s are 56. So, 8 is the answer. So, each person will get how many bouquets? 8. So, write down 8 bouquets. Clear, children? That's all for today's class. Practice well the division sums. It is a little difficult only. So, if you practice only, it will be easier for you, right? So, practice well the division sums, children. See you in the next class with a new chapter. Thank you.